Ano? pigeons.
Any added weight on the car?
Oops,
And you know, we knew Austin Wheatley would show up here to the race at Skagit, but we don't know, ever know otherwise where you'd show up, man. You were at some high limit shows or other shows, Midwest shows. You just were kind of just popping up, huh?
Yeah, we don't really know either, to be honest with you. We just whenever we can get time in our schedule or we're if work's not busy or if we get kind of the urge to go racing, we're a family team and we can go do it. We want to go do it.
Yeah, talk about, you know, last year obviously you had a wreck, and I don't know if we've talked since then on the podcast, but you know, that was a pretty big wreck for you. You were out, you missed the whole year, right?
Yeah, we had a really big summer of plans to go racing, and we just kind of abruptly got halted of that, and ever since then, we started back in beginning of June, I think was my first race back, but aside from that, yeah, the last 3 years or so, I think we've done less than 20 races, so it's kind of hard to stay in a rhythm like that.
Yeah, how has it been getting back in the rhythm? Was there any, is there anything when you get in a wreck like that? A lot of these guys can jump right back into it. What was it like when you have to take like time off like that?
I think after you do, if you did a full season, and then you had a mishap like that, and then you had to take some time off, you get back in, it wouldn't be so bad. But kind of every year, we're just only doing 10 or 15 races, and it's kind of, I feel like I'm not personally up to the par that I want to be, or the equipment that we have, the bar that we want to set. So I think from here on out, we've talked quite a bit, and we're going to do some more racing, and just, you know, life's getting shorter by the day. So we want to take advantage of what we have and go have some fun.
So what is the plan for the rest of the year? You're going to obviously probably run all the way to Gold Cup?
Yep, just Gold Cup, and then I mean we're just play by ear. We'll see how this weekend goes. You never know.
Yeah,
so after that crash, we had a whole summer of plans going, and we didn't get to any of that. So we're just gonna take it one day at a time and do this, and then do Gold Cup, and then see where we go.
Now what? And then obviously your business. We talked about that. A lot of the shirts you're wearing the Vapor Trail, but a lot of the shirts we see out here, you do, right? You design them, so. People don't even think there's more to you than just the racing.
Yeah, I think that's a lot of people in racing, to be honest. A lot of people have side businesses or full-time businesses, and the racing is a side thing, but and that's the cool thing about racing as well, is if you have a business in racing, a lot of people through the racing support those businesses. So the clothing side, and now the video game development side, I think it's kind of a passion of mine, and I wish I would have found it a little bit sooner, to be honest, but it's really hard to mesh the three together. You know, for racing, you have to be really really dedicated and committed, and the clothing stuff and just staying on top of your craft for anything. So I'm trying to balance it all.
So what kind of whose shirts have you done like in this pit area today?
Put
you on the spot,
I mean,
huh?
In this pit area? I don't know.
Or just some of the shirts that you've done. Some of the recent shirts you've done?
Not as many in this pit area, to be honest. The World of Outlaw guys, they kind of stick to the... A lot of the racing is in the Midwest and and the East Coast, so they use companies back there. So they're not.
But you do a lot of the local.
A good amount. Yeah.
And then what was the video game you said? What kind of video games are you
doing? It's an authentic sprint car experience. It's a realistic sprint car game for console and PC.
Okay.
It's fairly far along. So if you want to find more about that, just go to the Vapor Trail Studios YouTube page. And we're going to keep doing development and vlogs on that and keep people updated.
All right, well, who'd you like to thank with this whole racing deal? I know Dad's still helping you out, right?
Yeah, more than helping me out, it's his race team. So he's helping me out by letting me drive it. So it's my mom, my dad, Morrison Racing Engines, KPC Chassis, FK Shocks, Elite Wings. There's just a bunch of product sponsors that help us go around.
All right, well, good luck here at Skagit Speedway and down Elma.
Yeah, thank you.
This is Sean, and you're in the dirt, Cali Dirt Video. Press Sweet joins here right now, and getting ready for Skagit. And he's flying around with that. How you doing?
Yeah, good. Always excited to get up here to Skagit Speedway. Such a beautiful place. A little chilly tonight, but you know, Kevin Rudine and the crew up here, Peter Murphy, and all the hard work's really you know, showing off. The facility looks great. I got a lot of friends up here and always excited to be on the West Coast. So we've had a lot of good runs here at Skagit. Obviously hoping to have another good weekend.
I bet your crew likes the weather, huh?
I don't know. This is a little too cold. I mean, I don't think we're quite ready for fall yet. You know, it seems like the summer went by quick, but Chico next weekend, I'm sure it'll be much hotter. But I think the weather, as long as it's not raining and we get to race, we're happy.
Yeah, leave it to Washington to have 91 week and then this the next, right?
Yeah, I mean, you guys are always a little ahead on the cooling down up here in this North Pacific. So, but it's pretty, and like I said, the race has been good the last few years, so just excited to have a good, solid weekend here.
And a good car count.
Yeah, exactly. They're definitely working hard to build the car count back up, build the Sport 10 division back up, and, you know, start to show off. They brought the Dirt Cup back, and it's paying good money, and, you know, it's good money again here this weekend for this Outlaw Show. Three nights of good racing, so, yeah, I think more and more people are going to start hopping on board and getting 410s, and hopefully we can build that class all over the West Coast and have bigger events for sure.
And you played a part of this, actually, because with being a promoter on the West Coast, you have helped build this car count. We've got some California cars here, but you've helped kind of build 410 racing on the West Coast.
I think just influencers, you know, and people. I think we realize that the 410 class is really important to the ecosystem, and just, you know, changing some rules around and trying to, you know, get bigger events built up, along with the, you know, Peter Murphy and Kevin Brudine up here and Jim Allen with King of the West. And, you know, it's definitely a group effort. You know, all the promoters work really hard. It's an extremely tough business, so everybody's working hard to build these classes and keep them going so that, you know, the whole ecosystem can work.
All right. Now, you have a good season this year. You've been really busy, huh? Seems like a lot of stress, maybe, but you seem to be handling it well between running the full-time Outlaw deal and currently going for the fifth in a row. And then you're doing the high limit deal with Kyle and with those weekday races. Talk about how balancing it all.
Yeah, it's not easy. Definitely been a tough year as far as the travel and how much I have on my plate. But, you know, it's just something where I'm kind of transitioning, you know, to looking at things that are going to be, you know, after racing, what life after racing is going to look like. And you can't just quit racing cold turkey. So definitely, you know, seeing how the promoting side of it is. You know, the series I'm doing with Kyle's been a lot of fun in the midweek stuff, and we've had some great events. So, yeah, it's just, I don't know, it's challenging, but, you know, I think it's pretty rewarding in the same sense. And then obviously going for a fifth championship, and we're right in the thick of it. So, yeah, just trying to balance it all and make sure that I'm giving everybody 110% of everything I can.
All right, who'd you like to thank for all of this?
Well, obviously NAP Auto Parts is, you know, what makes our team go up and down the road. But we got a lot of great partners: Team ASC, Curb Records, Factory Kane, the Brumos Collection, Caravan Trailers, so Fuel Me. I think there's a lot of great partners that make all KKR go. And obviously this is Casey's home track, so he has a lot of fans and family here. So yeah, it's just fun to be here, and we appreciate everybody that makes KKR get up and down the road.
Well, good luck tonight, and thanks for the time.
Thank you.
This is Sean, you're in the dirt, Kyle, your video.
Clear from the car. If you're still.
Such a good girl. I know you're gonna go back. on a like a hot mile lap car.
I thought that last year.
Thank you.
sells the Jones right now. Man, for your first time here at Skagit, first time in Washington, huh?
Yeah. You know, I feel like if they get the track a bit smoother tomorrow, it's going to be a really, really racy racetrack. It's a great facility. You know, awesome. It's beautiful up here. I love being up here.
You probably learned a ton tonight, huh?
Yeah, you know, to try to stay on all four wheels, that was a task in itself. So, you know, we timed good tonight, which was a plus. He ran good in the heat. Drew the one or two, I don't remember which helped. So, led some laps, which is always good, but, you know, run third.
Kind of probably disappointed with that, but you're having such a great rookie season here. I mean, you know, it's a tough grind out here on this tour, isn't it?
Yeah, no doubt. It seems like late we've been, you know, top threes, top fours, top fives there, you know, back to back to back. So, you know, car feels good right now. Adam's got this thing rolling, so it makes my job a lot easier.
So what was the motivation to come out and run the whole tour this year? Because you guys were kind of just nitpicking stuff, you know, and we never saw you out this way, you know, but this year you decided to run the whole thing, so I was kind of looking forward to seeing you out here.
Yeah, all the perks and stuff that the Outlaws, you know, offer with pit passes, tow money, and the point fund at the end of the year obviously helps you get down the road. So racing, you know, hit and miss is great when you win a couple big races, but at the end of the year when there's no point fund to chase, it makes it a little tougher to go in the off season. So and you're racing the best guys in the world, you can't really argue with that. So felt like it would up my game and it up the team's game as well.
And they're saying this is some of the toughest Outlaw competition that ever been.
Yeah, I definitely feel that way. I don't know if everyone says that. Whatever era they race in, they probably think it's the toughest. But the way the equipment is now, all our motors run really good. The cars are pretty much all the same. And it comes down to, you know, a move here or there in the future with drivers. So, yeah, I mean, there's a lot of good cars out here right now, and they're all pretty much up here.
And you get to run against your brother now here on a few races here on the West Coast?
Yeah, definitely. It'll be good to go back home and race in front of hometown crowds.
Who'd you like to thank?
You know, Logan Contractors, Aspen Air, Matt Barbara, Brett Nearing. There's so many names in this car. Ted's Body Shop, Bobcat. There's a lot of guys that are a huge part of this thing. Rasmussen Group stuck with us. So it's cool to see how many guys, and it can't be much further from Iowa up here. So I'm not sure they're all watching on their vision.
But you've been to some, I mean, you've been here, but then when we get down to California, you've been to some of those tracks though.
Yeah, Hanford, Placerville, Chico are all definitely home tracks for me. So it'll be cool. I haven't been home since the beginning of last year, so it'll be a change for sure.
All right, well, good luck.
Thanks, man.
This is Sean, you're the Dirt, Kylie Dirt Video.
How's it going, guys?
Look at that!
You want me to wear this?
Yeah, try it! You try to turn, okay, your turn.
Yep. Sheldon Hotchild joins us right now. Picking up the win here at Skagit. Man, that's a great birthday present, huh?
Yeah, for sure.
So, how did you find that line here at Skagit Speedway tonight, huh? That was like the extra hot line, huh?
Yeah, I don't know. Just kind of had to try and go where they weren't going and figure a way out around them.
Because we watch you a lot, you know, and you like that high line, right? But sometimes the high line doesn't always work here at Skagit Speedway. You know, you can't go too high, right? There's a wall up there, but you found it tonight. And also 16th. So 16th is where you started, correct?
Yep.
There's not a lot of 16th and one. I don't know when the last time we saw someone come from 16th at Skagit Speedway to win one of these Outlaw races.
I don't know when that's happened from the Outlaws for a while. I think they just tweeted it, but yeah, that was pretty deep. So hats off to my guys. They did a great job and gave me a great car, so made it fun.
Got Levi in the pits with you again this week?
Yeah, we always got Levi when we come out west, and yeah, we love having him around. He does a great job.
I think you got a little guy behind you, huh?
Yeah, a little good luck charm too.
Yeah. What are you gonna do with all these apples that you had here behind you? They're not here now, but what do you do with the whole case of apples? You're gonna eat them all?
We're gonna eat them.
You make some apple pie, maybe?
Yeah, we got a big gang of people. We got apple a day. Turning 30.
How old are you now?
30.
Wow, Sheldon's 30. Can you believe that? All right, so who would you like to thank? I mean, you got a great crew behind you. I mean, you're always having an incredible year every year, but this year's another one solid year, huh?
This year's been a little up and down, but yeah, the whole NASA News Drink, West Tennessee Expediting, Frozen Farmer Car has been really good. Yeah, just keep trying to win here.
You're amazing when you say up and down. Up and down for you. You amaze me, Sheldon. Good. Congratulations, and we'll see you tomorrow night.
Yeah, thank you.
This is Sean, and you're in the Dirt, Kylie Dirt Video.
So good. Still?
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, no problem.